excitement of blown glass as an art medium began in the 1960s, largely through the creative and technical efforts of Dominick, Labino and Harvey, Littleton. Modest beginnings in a garage studio near the Toledo, Ohio Museum ignited the spark that gave birth to what can today be called a renaissance in art glass making. The masterful works of Dale Chihuly began to emerge out of this era. Labino, research consultant for Johns Manville Fiberglass of Ohio, lent his great technical ability in producing a formula for lower temperature glass, as well as designs for furnaces and equipment. His research and skill is evident in these sand core reproductions of Egyptian perfume and ointment containers, which he produced for the Toledo Museum. The originals date back to 1550 BC. Is the main ingredient of glass making, about 62 to 72%, to which he added smaller portions of sodium oxide and lime, together with metallic oxides for color. A heated fire brick kiln receives the mixture and becomes a taffy-like liquid in about 24 hours at 2100 degrees. Pipe carefully gathers the smooth liquid. Excitement stirs the soul of the artist as the creative process begins. The first gather is rolled or marvered on a steel table, blowing a bit of air after the first gather is essential to begin a container form. Elongation of the shape occurs by swinging it. It can also be used to cool the glass before the next gather. Sitting in his chair, he puts a neck on the form with a patella, after which he gathers more glass from the furnace. The following are processes which Labino demonstrated in his studio in 1967 near Grand Rapids, Ohio. Following are processes which Labino demonstrated in his studio in 1967 near Grand Rapids, Ohio. Nick Labino's contributions to blown glass art has been most significant. The high quality of his work, which captures light so beautifully, is found in numerous museums and galleries throughout the country. He and Harvey Littleton set the stage for a host of artists working in glass, including world-famous Dale Chihuly and his great school at Pilchuck in Washington State. Labino's work is virtually a symphony in glass. Harvey Littleton was professor of art with an international reputation in pottery at the University of Wisconsin, a former colleague of mine. I was permitted to film his studio and a demonstration in his glass shop in the summer of 1967. I was fascinated by what he was doing, little realizing that he became the leader of the new creative movement in glass art in the U.S. and abroad. Thank you. Today, Points to Remember takes you to the handsome First Pacific and City Center in downtown Seattle, which features the magnificent Prescott.